Henry Ossawa Tanner's painting of the flight into Egypt demonstrates how even seemingly incidental elements in a great work of art are in fact consequential to its success and meaning. As the Holy Family sets out on their journey, Mary rides a donkey and cradles the infant Jesus. Joseph follows beside them. They are led out of Bethlehem by a guide with a lamp. To visualize the threat of death that hangs over the child, Tanner has depicted a large shadow on the wall behind Mary and Jesus. Painted in 1923, this work exemplifies Tanner's modernist painting method. The oil paint is applied in thick glazes. Up close, the image dissolves into nearly abstract passages of material and gesture. These expressive marks of paint, these signs of the artist's creative touch, remind the viewer that this painting, like every work of art, is a fulfillment of a process in which the artist has made countless creative decisions. Looking carefully at this work, we can inventory some of Tanner's creative decisions and ask why he might have made them. For example, what purpose does the man in the right foreground serve in Tanner's painting? This guide is not mentioned in the Bible, and he seems unnecessary to the narrative. Tanner had depicted the flight into Egypt, which was one of his favorite subjects, several times before. But in these earlier works, Joseph, Mary, and Jesus are represented traveling alone. Therefore, the presence of this guide might initially seem out of place. But in a great work of art, nothing is extraneous. Every part of a successful work of art contributes something to its visual creation of meaning. In fact, this man is pivotal to the compositional integrity and sacred meaning of Tanner's painting. His presence is crucial to the painting's portrayal of mortal danger and spiritual urgency. The ominous mood in this depiction of the flight into Egypt depends on a dramatic juxtaposition of light and shadow. This contrast of light and darkness, particularly in the large shadow behind Mary, is key to the sense of danger and even death conjured in this nocturnal scene of clandestine departure. But every shadow needs a corresponding light source. To create the shadow behind and above Mary, Tanner needed to strategically place a light in the painting's lower foreground. This brings us to the important role that this guide has in the painting. He is the light bearer. In examining Tanner's painting, we can trace a series of his creative decisions. To visualize this moment of danger, Tanner needed a shadow. To create a shadow of death, he needed a light source. In order to place a light within his composition, Tanner introduced the guide carrying a lamp. While the guide is extraneous to the biblical story, his lamp is essential to the painting. Compared to some of Henry Ossawa Tanner's previous depictions of the flight into Egypt, this composition is more pictorially complex. This haunting work evidences Tanner's creative invention in visualizing the grave danger present in the Holy Family's nighttime escape.